Okay, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello everyone, we are from Group 6. Today we will discuss about causes of plant disease by fungi and bacteria. Before the presentation, let me introduce myself and my friend. My name is Fatih Lufika, with student number 251. My friends are Putri Gracia Ardana, with student number 255, Nida Amalia Mutakin, with student number 256, Kisti Nurani Praptawati, Diego Rasinatra, Asira Almas, dan Muhammad Ziaul Haq. Okay, first, we will talk about fungi. Characteristics of fungi. Fungi include multicultural organisms. Some are unicellular, have cell walls, generally do not move, do not have chlorophyll. The basic structure in the form of hyphae, reproduce asexually and asexually. And lastly, fungi cannot carry out the process of photosynthesis or produce organic material from carbon dioxide and water. The nature of live fungus. First is saprophyte, a living organism. Saprophyte fungi from object or dead organic materials. Saprophyte break down the remains of complex plant and animal materials into simpler materials. The result of this decomposition are then returned to the soil so that it can increase soil fertility. Second is parasites. Parasitic fungi absorb organic matter from living organism called host. Such fungi can be obligate parasites that are true parasite, and facultative parasites that are organism parasitic at first, then kill their host and live on the dead host as a saprophyte. Lastly, symbiont. Fungi can symbiotic with other organisms. Symbiosis with algae produce lichen, while symbiosis with coniferous root produce mycorrhizae.
There are four classes of fungi that causes disease. First, Ascomycota. Second, Basidiomycota. Third, Phytophthora. And the last one is Eutheromycota. Next. Ascomycota. Ascomycota belongs to the monopolytic group of fungi, has unicellular and multicellular bodies, and has small, elongated, insulated, multicleated hyphae, and has diameter of about 5 micrometers. Reproduction of these walls can be vegetative or generative. First, vegetative, namely in unicellular fungi, forming shoots, and in multicellular fungi, forming spores from conidia. Second, generative, which form ascus, which produce ascospora. These fungus that cause disease in plant, for example, first Keratocystis fimbriata, which causes cancer on cocoa, coffee, mango, coconut, and rubber. Second, Glomerula cingulata, causes anthracnose disease in various plants. And the last one is Mycospirale bagelei and Mycospirella arachidis, which causes leaf spot disease in peanut. Basidiomycota are fungi that has basidium, and the spores of this fungus grow into mycelium. When the mycelium covers the fruit body, this is called a basidiocarp. Basidiomycota has insulated hyphae, and its basidiocarp is clearly visible on the soil surface, which has virus patch such as umbrella, birds, or balls. This fungus causes disease in plants. For example, first Exobasidium fecens, Casa smallpox intilips, and Hemileila vastatrix, Casa scofflaxis ras. Second, Puccinia sorghi, Casa ras disease in sorghum, and the last one is Rigidoporus pugnosus, Casa white root disease in annual plants.
And number three is Phytophthora. This pathogen is a causes disease in cocoa plants. These pathogens can cause root disease with stem cancer and leaf blight that can interfere with growth and development cocoa plants, can even reduce production cocoa pods. Phytophthora can make cocoa roots root to the cocoa plants. This causes loss because it can reduce production. Fruit rot can occur at a various age of the fruit, since the fruit is still small until it is close to ripe. The color of the fruit changes, generally starting at the peak of the fruit or near the stalk, which quickly extends short to the fruit. Finally, the fruit turns back on the surface of the fruit that is sick and turns black. A white powdery layer appears, consisting of secondary fungi that form a lot of spores. And number four is Deuteromycota. Deuteromycota that often attack wood in wet condition. Wood rot due to fungi attack causes a significant change in the physical properties of wood. The degree of this change depends on the intensity of the fungal attack on the wood. Change in the physical properties of bitters wood include the surge in wood weight due to the loss of some chemical components of the wood. The color of the wood becomes darker or brownish or can be whiter, and also the wood smells that pierces the nose.
Bacteria. Next. Next. Bacteria are microorganisms that have one cell or commonly called unicellular. Bacteria don't have a cell nucleus. Bacteria is a prokaryote. But bacteria have a cell wall and germ. Bacteria have cosmopolitan properties, can survive autotrophs and heterotrophs, mostly move using flagella, produced excessively by binary fission, and various cell shapes, spiral, and rods. Bacteria structure. First, core area. In the bacterial cell, there is a nucleus composed of one of the DNA chromosomes. Therefore, bacteria are included in haploid microorganisms. Second, surface layer. On the surface layer of the cell, there is a mucous subcapsule that lines the bacteria cell. The bacterial cell wall is located between the capsule and the cytoplasmic membrane. Third, cytoplasm. Cytoplasm in bacteria is in the form of protoplasms in which there are granules. And the last, bacteria activator. Bacteria generally move using flagella found in the cytoplasm. These flagella are composed of an elastic protein called flagellin.
There are four class of fungi that cause this. 1. Eubacterial. 2. Actinomycetales. 3. Pseudomonadales. Next. Order Eubacteriales. Eubacteriales, the characteristic of this order are the cell are round or rods that are straight and separate. Sometimes it form colony in the form of chains. The locomotion is peritrichous or immobile flagellum. 1. Acetobacteriaceae. Its characteristic are that the cell are oval or rod shaped, similar to yeast cell. It live freely in the soil and is a nitrogen fixer. For example, Acetobacter crococcum, Acetobacter indicus, and Acetobacter agilis. 2. Rhizobiaceae. The characteristic of this family of bacteria are rod shaped cell, sometimes branch, often in symbiosis with leguminosae and form nodules on the roots and can feed nitrogen. Some example of symbiosis between bacteria and plants, among other. Next. Three, Enterobacteriaceae. This group of bacteria is often found in the respiratory and urinary tract of vertebrate. These bacteria are free living and also pathogenic, causing anaerobic fermentation of glucose, sometimes lactose. 4. Microsaceae. These bacterial cells are shaped like bullets, present in colony of detritus of the cubes of irregular mass. 5. Neisse. Riaceae, a feature of this family of bacteria is that the cells are bullet shaped, often in pairs. Example of this bacteria are as follow. 6. Lactobacillaceae, the characteristic of this bacteria are in the form of bullets or rod that can cause lactic acid fermentation. 7. Bacillaceae, the cell of this bacteria are rod shaped, can produce endospores under adverse environmental condition. Next.
Order Actinomycetales. Order Actinomycetales are gram-positive bacteria, one of which is characterized by high GC content. The cell will contain muriatic acid, Condylia has a nuclear envelope. The cell diameter range for 0.5 to 2 meter and can be killed or inhibited by many bacterial antibiotics. There are several families, namely 1. Mycobacteriaceae. The cell don't form mycelium. Example, Mycobacterium tuberculosis. The cause of tuberculosis or tuberculosis and leprosy, the cause of leprosy. So, Actinomycetae, forming mycelium and spores are formed in mycelium fragments. 3. Streptomycetaceae, forming an vegetative mycelium and mycelium. Example, Streptomyces aureofacins produce aureomycin as tricin produce streptomycin. Order of Pseudomodales. Order Pseudomodales are bacteria whose cells are split. The stem are straight or bent, sometimes joined together to form chains. The cell often contain photosynthetic pigment which are green in color and move by means of a polar flagellum. There are several families, namely Nictobacteriaceae or Nitrosomonas sp, Metanomodaceae or Metamonas sp, Theobacteriaceae or Theobacillus sp, and Pseudomonadaceae or Pseudomonas eruginosa. Example, in the Pseudomonas family, Pseudomonas solanaceum can cause wilt disease in chili plants.
How to know if a plant is attacked by fungus or bacteria? If the plant is withered by bacteria, the plant is uprooted, the roots are cut. If the disease is caused by bacteria, then the cut looks slimy and smell. Keep the root in water and wait for a few minutes. If it looks like smoke in the water, it can be ascertained that the wilt attack is caused by bacteria. Bacteria wilt attack very quickly. It can even take less than 3 days. Plant look wilt both day and night. If the plant withered by mushroom, if the root is cut, it is not slimy and smell. Meanwhile, if it's deep in water for a few minutes, it will not look like smoke as in a bacterial attack. The attack is relatively longer than the attack of bacteria. The plants look wilt during the day, but are fresh again in the afternoon.
Okay, this is all from us. If you have any question, please ask on the discussion page. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.